Welcome to the second section in our series on early and middle childhood, the teenager, and the senior years. This section is going to be on iron deficiency. We're going to start by talking a little bit about iron deficiency in basically toddlers in the early childhood years. The problem is, one of the problems that can happen with iron deficiency is not only not having enough intake, but also having children who consume lead. And you'd think that most children would not be doing that in these days as we're getting rid of a lot of lead paints, but old paint chips and certain toys and different metals can be in and around the house, and toddlers love to put things in their mouths. So they can end up absorbing some of that lead. They don't need to absorb a lot because they're very little. Iron and lead compete, so there becomes two issues, that there can be illness just from, and behavior problems just from the lead toxicity, but then also that will inhibit the iron from being absorbed. So there's also the problem of iron absorption. And initially the symptoms are very silent. That means that they're really not recognizable. The toddler or the younger child is not going to show or demonstrate any symptoms. But lead toxicity in particular can lead to injury of the kidneys and the brain and the nervous system. So what are some of the foods that can be eaten that would provide good sources of iron? Now remember, this is a problem for children because, you know, like the spinach here, they're generally not going to want to eat spinach. We also think of other good iron sources, which can be some, you know, ground meats, just like ground beefs, bean dips, roast beef, and even peanut butter. Enriched cereals, some types of rice and barley and tortillas can all have wheat. And then don't forget, of course, about our vegetables like snow peas and green peas and vegetable juices. Dried fruit actually can be good sources of iron as well. Very important that particularly the toddlers are getting enough iron. So iron deficiency, as I mentioned before, results in it can result on severe cases to anemia, but what's even more likely is the child will develop some behavioral problems but not actually be anemic, and that's a little bit harder to diagnose. So the best thing is just to get adequate sources of iron for toddlers and in early childhood. And this will finish our short section on iron deficiency.